Hey guys, welcome back. This is Dr. Duce bringing you another great music tech tip. Now today I'm going to be showing you another fantastic function in Logic known as Chord Trigger. Now the Chord Trigger function is available on Logic's software instrument channel strips, such as we're on this electric piano right here, and it's under the MIDI effects tab. So if you click here, you've got the arpeggiator and a range of other functions, but the one we're looking at today is the Chord Trigger. And this is what it looks like. You've got two virtual MIDI keyboards here, input and output. And at the moment, I've got certain notes assigned. So I'll show you what happens if I was to press the C3 on the input keyboard. You'll see that the output keyboard forms a shape, which is at the moment that chord is C-7. Don't worry about that for now. First thing we need to do is clear all of this. And in this tutorial, I'm going to be covering some very basic music theory. For those of you who already understand about chord formation, chord structures, that's fine. But for those who don't, I'm just going to break it down really, really simply. So what I'm hoping to accomplish in this tutorial is for us to be able to play back a simple chord sequence by just triggering single notes on the keyboard. Now the sequence that we're going to be using is made up of three chords, and the three chords are called minor triads, minor chords. The first chord is A minor. The second chord is D minor. And the third chord is E minor. Okay, so the next thing we want to do is program or teach the chord trigger module to play back a minor triad. Now, a minor triad chord is made up of three notes. The root note, which in our example is the note A. The minor third, which is C. And the fifth, which is E. Okay, later on I'll be doing more in terms of music theory, but for now just understand that we're using the root, minor third, and fifth. Okay, now what we need to do is program that into the input stage of the module. So we're going to hit learn, and on our MIDI keyboard, or I'm using my computer keyboard, my laptop keyboard, I'm going to hold keyboard keys H, K, and semicolon while the learn switch is on. Okay, let's go. Great. You will notice that we've got all these circles on all of the notes, and that means the chord trigger module has been programmed. Now, if I was to press any note on this MIDI keyboard here or on my computer keyboard, listen what happens. There we go. And you can see the output of A minor right there. And let's press another one. Let's try the keyboard note of D and the keyboard note of E. And there we go. That's E minor, D minor, E minor, A minor. Okay. Now this is fantastic because I can now move to another minor chord, maybe G minor, F minor, E flat minor, A flat minor, okay? Right, so that's how you program a basic minor triad. What we want to do now is apply this to our synth. Now we're going to use this analog pad, Logic Spheres. This is a stacked synth, meaning there are two or more synths combined together to create the sound. Let's go back to this and listen to what it sounds like. Right, that's the sound there. If we hit this little tab right here, you'll see it's combined with this one and this one. Right, so let's listen to that. And then listen to this one here. Okay, now, one thing to bear in mind is when you're working with stacked synths on the channel strip, we don't have the MIDI effects plug-in section, only on the individual synth channel strip. Now you can see it right here, and at the moment it's programmed with something else. I'm going to clear that, and I'm going to copy the settings from this chord trigger. Let's open this up again, copy that and paste it here. This time, there we go. Okay, so this one is assigned to the electric piano, which I use to program. Let's close that one. Now this one is the chord trigger for the analog spheres. Let's go to the bass layer, and we're gonna go in here, chord trigger. Let's see what's programmed here already. Right, that's minor seventh. We're gonna clear that, and we're just gonna paste what we have in the memory. Let's try that now. Right, great. So let's do a quick recording. I'm just using my mouse pointer and clicking on individual notes. There we go. Quantize that. You'll see the chords being played on both of these modules. Down here in the piano roll, all that's being played is a single note. Okay. Now the chord trigger module is a fantastic way to help you build up chord progressions within your production. It's excellent and it's really quick. However, I will always advise you to learn the basics of music theory, meaning learn the basics of chord structure, chord formation, chord progressions. There's loads of stuff on YouTube and elsewhere that will help you with this. And also I'll be doing a short series on the basics of chord progression, chord formation, and that sort of thing. So I really do hope this video has helped you. Please remember to comment, like, and subscribe to the channel. This is Dr. Duce. I'll be back real soon. Peace.